Hello students, welcome you all to this session. So in the previous sessions we had started a chapter called as natural resources. Yes, in that we had seen different types of natural resources like renewable and non-renewable resources. We had seen with examples also renewable and non-renewable resources. Then we had studied about ecosystem also, forest ecosystem, grassland ecosystem, renewable resources, renewable and non-renewable. Renewable resources are the one which can be renewed or regenerated are called renewable resources. Non-renewable are the one which cannot be regenerated in the nature. They are called as non-renewable resources. And the use should be in limited condition. Otherwise, those resources like petroleum products or fossil fuels will not be remaining for the next generation. Okay, and in previous session we also seen about water resources, the uses and over exploitation of groundwater and surface water. Then we had seen dams, construction of dams, what is the benefit of constructing dams as well as some disadvantages of constructing dams. And we had seen floods, drought, what are the things happening in the nature. They are all natural calamities occurring in the nature. Then also we had seen some disputes between interstate as well as international disputes for water or the supply of water. As you know, water is very essential for all living organisms. Okay, now we have come to end of this chapter. So in today's session we are going to discuss about energy resources. This is the last session of this chapter, that is energy resources. Energy, it is a kind of renewable resource. So two types categories are there in energy, renewable and non-renewable. So first we'll discuss about renewable. As you know, there are two categories. Already you know the meaning of renewable means whatever the resource which can be renewed is called as renewable. And one thing remember students, renewable resources are always abundant in nature, means they are more in huge quantity you can say, because they are renewed now and then. How much you want you can use it, but again it can be gained back. That is called as renewable resources, and it does not exhaust, so it is abundant in nature. Point number one, abundant in nature means it is present in huge quantity. It do not exhaust. It do not or does not exhaust means completely over, means it is present in the environment. Then for example, sun, you can say sun is the most important example or easily available example for renewable source of energy, that is sun, or you can say the solar radiation. Sun, that we get solar radiation, we call it as solar radiation, or the sun's rays which are getting for different activities or performing various metabolic activities in both plants and animals. Okay, now we'll see what are the adverse effect it is playing on our environment, adverse effect on environment. Biogas and fuel wood are other forms of energy. Biogas and fuel wood are other examples of renewable sources of energy, or can say they are natural and renewable energy. They are examples of renewable sources of energy. Okay, so once again, renewable. Renewable means they can be renewed or regenerated in the atmosphere. So point number one is they are abundant in nature, present in the nature in huge quantity. They do not exhaust. Example sun, that is we are getting solar radiation from the sun. And example, other examples of renewable are biogas and fuel wood, which are natural and renewable sources of energy. They are natural. Yes, you already know these points. Next, coming to non-renewable, that is coal, oil, natural gas, or can say petroleum products, they are non-renewable resources. They are also called as fossil fuels. Non-renewable, as the name indicates, non-renewable means they cannot be renewed in the atmosphere. They get exhaust soon. Coal, petroleum, etc. Together they are called as fossil fuels. They are called as fossil fuels. They get exhaust soon in the atmosphere. And they use as commercial form of energy, as we use petroleum, diesel for our vehicles, you can say, for transportation, etc. So they are called as commercial energy. They form commercial energy. They are coming under commercial energy. Okay. So this is already know about renewable and non-renewable resources. Growth energy needs. As you know, students, energy is one of the most important requirement of every living being. It may be sun, solar energy, or it may be renewable or non-renewable. Human beings, we are depending on every kind of energy, and the energy requirement is recently increasing due to rapid industrialization. Energy need is increasing rapidly at a faster rate. Why? Due to industrialization. So earlier, in olden days or few years ago, there were not much of industries, but now in this generation, present generation, there are more number of industries, factories, you can say, where we require more amount of energy, especially the electrical energy, you can say. And in home also, you can see, we are all more dependent on the electrical energy. Okay, so energy requirement is rapidly increasing due to rapid industrialization and dependence on comfort and luxurious life. See students, every day ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೇಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಹೇಗಿರ್ತವೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕರೆಂಟಿಂದ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಿರ್ತೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಟಿವಿ, ಫ್ರಿಜ್, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ, ಆಟೋಮೊಬೈಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಯನ್ಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಲಕ್ಸುರಿಯಸ್ ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಕ್ಸುರಿಯಸ್ ಲೈಫ್, ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಕ್ಸುರಿಯಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಅವರ್ comfort and luxurious life, we are all depending on energy, that is electrical energy, which is a renewable source of energy. Okay, next, growing energy is due to some following factors. This is increasing due to some following factors. What factors are there for the growth or increase? Some factors you can see. Number one, growth of human population. Yes students, very important thing. So whatever resources are available in our nature, you can say, or the things available in nature, why we are facing certain issues, or you can say certain crisis, because the main or the most important reason is our population, increasing population. So growth of human population, the reason for all these things is increasing human population. As population increases, then our needs also increase, right? For food, you can say, or shelter, accommodation, employment. So nam janasankhya hech aagta aagta in aagta hogutte. We require food, we require more water, we require more space to live, we require more buildings, we require jobs. So due to population increasing, our needs increases. Okay, then coming to industrialization process and agricultural advancement. Already we have seen here, industrialization and agricultural advancement. See students, nowadays agriculture also, there are so many scientific techniques have been used, scientific equipments have come for easy method for agriculture. Earlier crops were growing by some old methods, traditional methods use martidru, but igella thumba machines bandide, thumba technology helpful aagtide igin kaaladalli. So agriculture advancement attracted to public shifting heaters, fridge, lights, adu helta idinalla, due to our comfort life, luxurious life. Okay, we are using fridge, we are using lot of lights, heaters. ಸೊ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೇಗೆ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಹಳೆ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಂಗಿತ್ತು, ಒಂದು ದೀಪ ಹಚ್ತಿದ್ರು ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಈಗ ತುಂಬ ಒಂದು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಲೈಟ್ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀರ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ, ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, product application, aluminium, steel, they're all depending on energy, extraction of some metals, aluminium, potassium, phosphorus, copper, gold, silver, they're all metals by which we're extracting, we require energy. Next, coming to transport advancement, see, ಈಗ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿಂಗ್ ಜನರೇಟೆಡ್, ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್. ಈಗ ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದು ಇಲ್ಲದ್ರೆ 4 ಜನ ಇದ್ದರೆ 4 ಗಾಡಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಈಗ ಆ ವೆಹಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆಹಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್, ಮೋರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋಲ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ಪೆಟ್ರೋಲಿಯಂ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ಡೀಸೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿನ್ಯೂವೇಬಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್, ಎಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೇಚರ್. Right, once they are exhaust, once they exhaust, then your energy is not available for the next generation. So advancement in transportation also leads to the loss of energy. Advancement of transportation, transport system. Right, now how do you go to school or how do you go to college? Right, you go by bus. Now every individual brings bike or come by car, what happens? Lot of petrol is wasted. Petroleum products are required for your vehicle to function. Then what happens? Slowly, the natural resources go on depleting in the nature. And then after the next generation, it will not be available for the next generation. So, transportation advancement, non-fuel uses in chemicals, paints, etc. There also sort of chemicals are being used, non-fuel uses. These are called as non-fuel uses. Okay. Now if we come to household sector, how much percent of total energy we are using, energy consumption? 75% of total energy consumption is under household sector. How much? 75%. So, among the total energy available in the environment, 75% of energy is under household sector. So, household sector is consuming 75% of total energy consumption. Okay. And in rural areas, 90% of it is used in cooking. In rural areas, 90% utilized in cooking. So, you know, ಹಳ್ಳಿಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಏನು ಒಲೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಡುಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್, ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕುಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್. 90% ಆಫ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕುಕ್ಕಿಂಗ್. ಇನ್ 20th century, ಸೊ ಇನ್ನು 20th century ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಬಿಕೆ ಮೇಜರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಥರ್ಮಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಇನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಟ್ವೆಂಟಿಯತ್ ಸೆಂಚುರಿ we are more and more dependent use of electricity. Earlier 20th century munche ashtond electricity use illila, right? Even they were no electricity ne illila kaaladalli. Then they used to light lamps, deepagalu hastidru, right? So after 20th century, after invention of electricity, most of our needs, we are all depending on electricity, electrical appliances. According to planning commission, according to planning commission, 80% of rural electrification, we are depending on rural electrification, development of infrastructure facilities. Simple aagi helbeku antandre, due to industrialization, urbanization, rural areas have also been switched on to so much of development in electricity, electrical appliances. Madalkal halligalalli ashtond use electric use illilla, but allu kuda enagutade, 80% people are using or depending on electricity. And development of infrastructure facilities, infrastructure means surrounding, you can say the nature or the buildings, you can say infrastructure. Okay. Next, and what is the use, alternative energy sources? You know, we have seen so many uses where energy being used and what is the percentage of energy both in rural as well as urban areas, and what are the main reasons for the use of this energy, that is renewable and non-renewable sources of energy, and by how much percent of energy is being used in household, industries, rural areas, etc. Then by seeing all these factors, ಏನು ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಯೂಸನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಏನಾದರೂ ಅಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್? ನಾವು ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿವ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಬೈ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಸಂಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿವ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಅಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ utilize or we can just prevent the loss of energy. Use of alternative energy sources. Alternative energy, apart from these other natural resources, we can use so many other resources like solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, non-traditional biomass and biogas. They are solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, biogas and biomass production. These are some of the alternative sources of energy or alternative energy resources, we can say. Number one, everybody know about solar energy. It is the most abundant and commonly available, and you know about it, solar energy. Where do we get from solar energy? From the sun. Yes, sun is the main source of energy, solar energy, naturally available, non-exhaustible, ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಸೂರ್ಯನ ಕಿರಣಗಳು ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ಅಥವಾ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ವಾತಾವರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ನೈಸರ್ಗಿಕವಾಗಿ ಸಿಗುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಎಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್, ರಿನ್ಯೂವೇಬಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೆ, ನಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಸ್ಟಿಬಲ್. ಸನ್ಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ನಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಸ್ಟಿಬಲ್. The potential is 15% of energy needs. It is supplying to us 15% of energy needs we are getting from sun's energy. It is naturally available, non-exhaustible source. And it is supplying us 15% of energy needs we are getting from solar energy. It is used for cooking, water heating, agriculture, and you know, so many solar panels have been fixed for heating, water heaters, for electricity also. We get electricity, we can produce electricity from solar panels. So these are all things by which we are getting solar energy. There are three methods are there: solar thermal energy, solar voltaic and solar energy. Once again, solar voltaic energy, solar thermal energy and solar energy are the three types of or three methods of using this solar energy. Number two, wind energy. Wind energy, it is second alternate source of energy. It is environmental friendly, non-pollution and easily available. Wind andre gaali, wind energy, and it is development in hilly area. Iga salpa high altitude, if you go to some high altitude areas, if you go to the top, there is lot of breeze or wind, ke tumba gaali irutte, illi kadme irutte, but as you go to the top, ಅದರ ಗುಡ್ಡ ಅಥವಾ ಬೆಟ್ಟ ಹತ್ತಿರ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ತುಂಬ ಗಾಳಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ವಿಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬೈ ದೋಸ್ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ಸ್. ಆಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಯರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್. ಹೌ ಡು ದೇ ಮೂವ್? ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ವಿತ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಂಡ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಗಾಳಿ ಬೇಕು, ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ವಿಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಜನರೇಟೆಡ್. ಇದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಲೋ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಡೋ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ, ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ಸ್ ಹೇಗಿರಬೇಕು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಅದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ವೆದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೂವ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎನ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ, ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೇಚರ್, ರೈಟ್? ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಲ್ಲಿ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್, ಗುಡ್ಡದ ಮೇಲೆ ಬೆಟ್ಟದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರ್ತವೆ ಈ ಥರ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತವೆ, ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. How much of energy needs it is supplying to us? 25 to 50% of energy needs. 25 to 50% of energy needs we are getting from wind energy. In 1986, it was first developed in 1986 in states like Karnataka, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Odisha. Different states in our country have been using this wind energy from these turbines. So this is about the wind energy. Number three, wave and tidal energy. Third one. वेव एंड टाइडल एनर्जी इदेल्लिंद सिगुत्ते निमगे टाइड्स अलेगळु वेव्स अंदरे अलेगळु टाइड्स अंदरे इतर अदितर अलेगळने नदियल्लि समुद्रदल्लि बर्ता इर्तवे प्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम वेव्स ऑफ टाइड्स ऑफ ओशन्स एंड सी समुद्रदल्लि नीरिन अलेगळु अदक्के टाइड्स अंतारे ओशन्स एंड सी फ्रॉम देयर आल्सो द एनर्जी कैन बी जनरेटेड Tides of wave should not be less than 25 feet. If the wave frequency is less than 25%, then the energy cannot be produced. So the frequency should be more, not less than 25. So we are discussing about tidal wave and tidal energy produced from ocean and seas, that is waves and tides of oceans and seas. Tides of wave should not be less than 25 feet. should not be less than 25 feet andre alegalu hegirbeku 25 feet ginta kadme irabadu more high waves should be there in the sea and ocean to produce energy that is called as wave and tidal energy that is established in states like Gujarat Many states have developed these kind of wave and tidal energy. Okay. Next coming to geothermal energy. Next one is geothermal energy. Geothermal energy. Okay. Now you know geo means earth. Thermal means temperature. So this can be produced through hot water and superheated stream of hot spring produced through hot water. It is mainly produced through hot water or you can say hot water springs, superheated steam of hot spring. In India, there are 46 hydrothermal areas. Hydrothermal andre alli temperature tapamana tumba jaasti irutte. Temperature increases above 150 degree Celsius. That is very very essential for glass house to grow vegetables. So there are so many geothermal areas. Geothermal areas where temperature is 150 degree Celsius. The temperature it increases that is up to 150 degree Celsius. Hydrothermal areas you can say hydrothermal areas where temperature exceeds more than 150 degree Celsius. That is required for temperatures to grow in glass houses. Next one hydroelectricity. Hydro means water. As you all know, water is very very essential. It is called as liquid of life, right children? So it is very essential for drinking, domestic purposes, you know. Apart from that, water is very essential for generating electricity. That is called as hydroelectricity. Very very essential for producing electricity. Produced through dams. Already we have seen in previous session about construction of dams, right? ಅಣೆಕಟ್ಟು ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ತುಂಬ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ ನಾವು ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ರೈನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಡ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಯುಟಿಲೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ಸ್ 15% ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಟರ್ಬೈನ್ಸ್ stored water through dams that is used for conducting or producing electricity called as hydroelectricity hydro means water next coming to atomic energy so many alternative energy sources are there ಆಟಮಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಆಟಮಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆಟಮಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಇನ್ ಬಯಾಲಜಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕೌಡಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೀನ್ ಹೌ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ದ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಸಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಟು ನಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಹೌಸಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕುಕಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಚೀಪ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಚೀಪ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಚ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಕೌಡಂಗ್ ದ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮಿಥೇನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಆನರೋಬಿಕ್ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಅ ಮಿಥೇನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ CH4 ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಮಿಥೇನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಆನರೋಬಿಕ್ ಡಿಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಸಜ್ ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯೂರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯೂರ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಚೀಪ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬಯೋಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಬರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ fossil fuels such as forest, agricultural products and urban waste. That is called a biomass and biogas is produced from manure. So they are cheap and easily available source of energy. So this is all about the different alternative sources of energy. Solar energy, wind energy, wave and tidal energy, geothermal energy, hydroelectricity, atomic energy, biomass and biogas. So these are all the alternative sources of energy by which we can we reduce the use of consumption of energy. Now we'll see the case study of energy resources in different parts of our state, you can say, especially in Karnataka. Case studies of energy resources. What is the use of case study? What is the meaning of case study? Case study means wherever these things have been happen or any kind of approval is done, case study. ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ತಗೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಹೇಳಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅದರ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಬೇಗ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಕೇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ BERI ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ energy for rural India BERI biomass energy for rural India that is in some parts of villages of Karnataka nam rajyadalli kelav halligalalli ಇದನ್ನು ಕೇಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಹೆಡಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ವಿಲೇಜಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಲೊಕೇಶನ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ 2001 and implemented in 5 village clusters in the district of Tumkur and Karnataka it consists of 28 villages in Tumkur district of Karnataka ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತಿದು ಬಯೋಮಾಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಫಾರ್ ರೂರಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ 2001 It was done, implemented in 5 village clusters consisting of 28 villages in Tumkur district of Karnataka. 28 villages in Tumkur district of Karnataka. This case study was done or this concept of biomass energy for rural India was established in 2001 location in Tumkur district of Karnataka that is 28 villages of Tumkur district in Karnataka okay What are the agencies and supporters? Which all agencies were supporting this? Agencies and supporters, we'll see. Agencies and supporters. Number one is Government of Karnataka. First it should be get approval through Government of Karnataka. Karnataka Sarkara. Number two, Gram Panchayat's people representatives. Recently we have seen Gram Panchayat election. What is their name? Yes, so Gram Panchayat people's representative. Gram Panchayat people's representative. Representatives are the supporters of such kind of rural areas. Rural and halli galu, villages or taluk, small villages you can say. UNDP. Union National Development of Program. Union National Development Program, UNDP. MNRE, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. MNRE, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy also is the agencies and supporting this program. Next, GOI, Government of India. Government of India. This is state level and this is national level. So from every sides you have to get the approval and support for such kind of programs, that is biomass energy for rural India. As you know, we have seen discussed today about energy resources. Energy resource is renewable, but still the use of that resource should be at a limited condition. Otherwise, if it is more and more, why it is utilized more and more? Because of the population, increase in the population. So one case study you are studying here, that is Biomass Energy for Rural India, BERI, where it is located, started in 2001 in 5 village clusters and started in 28 villages in district of Karnataka, that is Tumkur district. Tumkur jilleyalli madlu prarambha madiddu 2001 ralli. Who are the agencies and supporters here? Government of Karnataka, Government of India, Gram Panchayat People's Representatives, MNRE, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So, these are all the agencies and supporters of this case study called as Biomass Energy for Rural Development or Rural India, BERI. So, here completes your chapter called as Natural Resources. Natural resources. Under this chapter, what all we have studied, once again we'll recall. So main thing, got remember the meaning of natural resources types, renewable and non-renewable resources with examples. Then coming to first resource you have seen, that is land resource. So it is the most important valuable land resource. Land usage in India, classification of land usage in India you have seen. Then coming to soil as a renewable resource, importance of soil, functions of soil. And use of land at global level. At global level, our land is being distributed under forest, some under cultivable land, some under non-cultivable land. So what is the distribution? Then coming to soil erosion, the loss of topmost layer of the soil is called soil erosion. Then what are the preventive measures that led to desertification? What are the causes of desertification? That is deforestation, overgrazing of animals, mining and quarrying, river valley project and dams, then over exploitation of minerals, dams, problems of dams, biodiversity of tribal people. We have discussed about tribal people also, because they're all depending on forest, they're living in the forest for their livelihood. Next we have seen water use and over exploitation of surface and groundwater also we had studied. Then we also discussed about floods, drought, causes for drought, interstate disputes, international disputes. Then last one, today we have started with energy resources. Under energy resources, we have seen growing energy needs, how due to industrialization, urbanization, our need of energy increases. Okay. Then also we had seen use of alternative energy sources like solar energy, wind energy, wave and tidal energy, geothermal energy, hydrothermal energy, atomic energy, biomass, biogas, etc. Next, coming to last one, case studies of energy resources, that is BERI, biomass energy for rural India. In different parts of Karnataka, in district of Tumkur, about 28 villages have been started this program for consumption, or can say for saving the energy resources. So this is all about the chapter called as natural resources. Here completes the chapter of called as natural resources. In next session we'll start with the another chapter called as biodiversity. Thank you.